Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Here we are for a really nice show. Actually, it's been kind of going on. This is Thanksgiving week, and the show kind of started earlier this week. It's called the Houston Autorama, and today on Saturday they have like a special section for tuners. So I had to come and check it out, called Tuner Galleria. So never been to this show before. It's in downtown Houston, the convention center. So it's something, you know, brand new and can be checking out.
Precision something.
Nice. Man, this blue is awesome.
One of my favorite FRSs in Houston. Super, super clean build. Nice turbo setup. Got the polished TEs. Very, very clean interior. Very, very unique M4 build.
Look at that lift. Man.
The amount of detail on this thing is just insane. With the LEDs in the roll cage, or outside the roll cage.
But look at that interior, look at this seat.
Not really sure what seat this is, but my god. My favorite Mark IVs in Houston. Perfect, perfect from every angle. Look at the 350Z with the Rocket Bunny kit. One of my favorite front ends. Oh, the engine bay in this WRX is something else. Man, I love that. Titanium piping for the air cooler. Has the intake manifold all color matched. Everything purple, man, nice. Another one with awesome race seats in it. Roll. Definitely a blast from the past. Had one of these back in the day, GSX, all-wheel drive, the 2.0 turbo. Not really sure on the turbo setup that he has. You can barely see it through the carbon fiber hood here, but I've heard him leaving some car shows and this thing really puts down some power. Super, super clean. Continuing with the Mitsubishi theme, we have the 3000 GT right here. VR4, twin turbo, V6. Very, very clean. One of the nicest 240SX setups in Houston. We have the S14 with like an S15 front end conversion. Of course, you see the 2JZ right here. As you can see, it's a 93. It has the S15 front end on it. This thing has an amazing amount of work done to it. Look at how nice that interior is. Chassis mounted wing. Extremely low S2000. Probably on purpose. I think this is status, but I don't know. But, yeah, that's not even a finger off the ground. Super sweet. Love S2000. Kind of the reason I have my car today, the FRS. You know, this is the original 86. I think a lot of us grew up, you know, seeing these as, you know, beginning drift cars and whatnot. I mean, these things are just super hard to find this clean. Nothing screams some power like a LS swap 240. Love the body kit on this thing. Just in case the LS motor isn't enough, got some extra nitrous juices in the back here. I'm not really sure if the camera can do justice, but this paint job is amazing. It's almost like a midnight blue kind of style. And always been a fan of the Advan racing wheels. Kind of gives it that kind of proper fitment for an older 90s DDM kind of car. Kind of a familiar for some of the people that saw the Tuner Evo video. This actually picked up quite a few awards at the Tuner Evo show. Bulk racing, TEs, carbon fiber everywhere. Haven't really seen those taillights on an FD before. Really sweet. But it's green. This green is something else. It's immaculate. And that splitter is something else. I don't think I've ever seen a skyline this high off the ground. I mean, definitely need some coilovers, some anything to take that monster truck up. But man, at the end of the day, it's an actual R33 GTR skyline. Love them. Never get tired of seeing these NSXs. Here's a build list of it. This thing is just so clean. Bright seats. Man, even look at how clean that engine is. Not sure if this guy ever drives it. Oh man. Probably one of the most iconic colors on a Skyline. You definitely see them on the R34s, but not as many on the R32s, but man, Skylines with the TEs. Super nice. And then you continue on to the R33. And then this one. Extremely low. Super nice. I think that's kind of the best color combination. Silver with carbon fiber. Nice front mount air cooler. I have another Nissan next to a Silvia. One of the fan favorites, obviously, is the original Evo. That definitely aftermarket turbo. And lots of stuff on it. Another go lift here. I love those Recaro Smith. Nice touch. Something I haven't ever seen in person was one of these Resvani SUVs. The tank. I mean, just completely awesome. I mean, look at it. The winch built in right into the front bumper. All steel, man, look at it. Camera set up. LED light bar on top. Man, this thing is insane. Kind of a car that a lot of us grew up loving. Here's the Dukes of Hazzard. There's a 69 Dodge Charger. Oh my god, look at those tires in the back. And those iconic taillights when he's running for the police. So sweet. I haven't always been the hugest Dodge Charger fan, but I mean a Hellcat. And this wrap is pretty sweet actually. And that wheel mix up, man. That is one clean build. That's one next to it's nice too. And then we have the good old track hawk in the back here. Ooh, man. Nice color. This is for all those lowrider fans. 63 Impala on the switches. Gotta have the dice hanging. Look how clean that is. Man. I think I found my favorite car of the show. The iconic 280Z. 75 2 plus 2. Oh my god, look how clean this thing is. This is absolute perfection. Look at that diffuser. Man, that is a wide body. 280Z. My god, this thing is sweet.
Remember whenever I showed you that card and asked you if it was a keyboard?
Yeah.
Definitely always on the bucket list to get a nice 280Z build. Always has been my favorite muscle car. Especially when you have it, the meats in the back. kind of lift or drop the front end. 454 big block, all chromed out. Oh man, I love to just get in there and rev it up. This lives up to the everything's bigger in Texas. That kind of tells you how tall this is. The back bumper is above the guy. And you can tell in the back, is just filled with subwoofers. Wow. Definitely remember how these Mazda B2200s used to be like this and the Chevy S10s were like the biggest lowrider trucks. Definitely don't see one of these anymore. But super, super clean. See what he has in his bed. Definitely have never seen a Honda hatchback like this before. I mean, you can see the speakers all over, but look at the interior. He took the driver's side and passenger side and just put one super fancy center drive in there. One seat Honda Civic. That's definitely unique. See what he has from Mother up here. Okay, nice. Nice simple build, but that's definitely a very unique interior.